kubwa kwamba kama singeweza kusaidika na shirika hili nisingekuwa niko hapa. Kwa hivyo wanafunzi wote tunapitia katika shirika hili na kupitia njia za kusaidiwa na mashirika tofauti tofauti. Tukipata nafasi hizo tusitumie vizuri ya kuboresha maisha ya jamii ili watu waweze kutambua kwamba basi kupitia misaada tofauti tofauti wewe unatoka mahali na kufika mahali. Nitambue hayo ya kwamba kweli shirika hili limetuwezesha kama jamii. Mtandusi kidogo nitambue uwepo wa Steve ambaye ndabadilisha kidogo vitabeni niweke kizungu kidogo. Kwa mimi nimezoea sana siku hizi kuongea Kitaita na Kiswahili. Leo kizungu kinanipiga chenga. Lakini Mungu atanisaidia. Pia mtambua uwepo wa ndugu yangu rafiki yangu mheshimiwa kutoka Mbololo watu ambaye anaingia sasa. Mheshimiwa karibu sana. Mheshimiwa Mzuga ama mwalimu Mzuga aliniambia kama ni mambo ya elimu mheshimiwa siwezi kosa kuja maana mimi ni mwalimu. Na nitampatia nafasi wakati ukifika. Kwa hivyo karibu sana mheshimiwa mwalimu Mzuga Lawrence kutoka Mbololo watu rafiki yangu wa karibu. Steve, on behalf of the Kasigau community, because I stand here to represent the people that some of them are seated here today and some of them are missing because of other duties. Take this from my heart that as a leader, when I have undergone through the same organization to be where I am today, we don't take this lightly because it means so much to each and every one of us. Mr. Steve, with your family that founded this organization 204, recognizing Megan, Isaac, and Alex, who are the four founders of this organization, which used to be called A Better Education of Miramonte High School, because it was founded on the basis of the high school students at Miramonte High School. This organization has come up to transform so many lives of students, me included. Mr. Steve, we appreciate this effort, your tireless effort and commitment, despite the challenges that you have faced as an investor and as a donor, but you have always remained resilient and trusted us. Take this from us and take this from me as a leader representing the Kasigau community. You mean so much to this community. We don't have so much to pay you and repay back, but maybe given chances like I'm holding a leadership position today, is also to impact other people's lives, directly or indirectly, as a way of appreciating. When I was working in a bank and three boys that followed me to come and work for A Better Education Club, I was a bit hesitant. I didn't take it so fast. He had to give me 1 month of thinking around it. Because I told him, Steve, I have a career I'm chasing in the banking. And Nairobi has a lot of opportunities for me ahead. Why do you want me to go back to the villages and work in the village? But when I looked at his commitment to service for humanity, I also had to sacrifice my banking career and come back to work for the community. It was not an easy decision. He knows very well, because I told him to give me 1 month. But from heart, I could see his commitment to see a Kasigau community transform. He said, go back and work for your brothers and sisters in the village. I'll support you. And Steve, I never regretted that decision. As much as it was a hard decision to make. It was a very hard decision, yes. Because nobody else can advise me to go that direction and say, why are you leaving your banking career and go back to the village and take a risk in an organization that is not well embedded in terms of job security? It was very dangerous in terms of job security because I looked at building a career in the banking industry. I wanted to be a banker because I pursued a course related to banking, that is finance, in Kenyatta University 2011 when I graduated. So when I was given a chance to work in a bank, I felt I was in the right place where I can exercise my finance and business studies. And then Steve comes to me after 2 years in the banking industry, go back to work with a better education in Kasigau and help your brothers and sisters to access education just as you did. It was not easy. Even if it's you, you could have not decided the same way. Living in Nairobi as a city with so many opportunities, it was not easy at all. But I tell you today, I have never regretted that decision. Because I have been able, with your leadership and support, Mr. Steve, to make sure this organization survives to where it is today. We have students who are graduating this year here. After I came in, We have students who are in the universities today who are proceeding with their studies. We have made this organization to go to where it is today, and today we can celebrate 20 years of achievement. This is so much grateful to the people of Kasigau. We appreciate. I also want to thank Granton Maganga, who came over to take over, because some people are asking questions here. What happens to Abe after you go to politics? I remember one day I had a meeting with Kathy in Nairobi, with Steve, and she asked me a very pertinent question. Are we going to get your replacement, Amos, if you step out of a better education club? What will be the future of a better education club? But I told him this is an organization we all hold in our hearts. And as a leader, I will still hold it in my heart to see this organization thrive, to reach many and help so many people in this area. And I'm thankful to Grant who came in and put in the shoes of making sure a better education walks the talk of a better education in Kasigau. He's a product of a better education club, and I have so much confidence and trust in his leadership to take this organization to the next level. So many people living in Kasigau were worried that when they step out and join politics, that this organization will be shaken, because it has had an experience of a political interference, and felt that its future is also looking very dangerous when it involves itself with politics. But I want to assure you that as a leader leading this community in the assembly, I'm at the forefront to protect not only a better education club, but any other organization that is working to uplift the humanity of the people who are unprivileged to this society, so that they can raise to a certain level and become self-reliable and independent. So rest assured, Mr. Steve, that there will be total support from the political leaders. That's why some leaders are sitting here today. And any time I've given myself, I've always introduced myself to Steve and the team, to other leadership and leaders' position in this country, so that tomorrow, even in the absence of Amos or any other leader, this organization will be able to thrive, to be able to help the community where it can at best. I appreciate so much that you still believe and trust in every one of us here today. This organization is founded on the basis of trust, and you have trusted us with millions of money to transfer to students and to departments and organizations to better lives of the people of Kasigau. Please, together with your family and donors, that I cannot mention all of them here, let them take this, that we are still committed to making sure that this organization thrives in the future. It's fully behind our hands. We know the leadership currently in this organization, and the leadership of Granton Maganga, is going to go to another level. With those remarks, allow me